Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a social justice champion with a passion dedicated to the empowerment of the LGBTQ community. And he continues to be an advocate for the youth and the black community. Please welcome back to the Circle, Executive Director of the National Black Justice Coalition, Mr. David Johnson. Yes.
Yes. You're always awesome.
Yes. Hey, friend. Okay, so your shirt, let's start there.
Yes.
It reads, "Black boys deserve to grow up too." Right. Mm-hmm. Tell us why you chose to wear this t-shirt.
Yeah, I appreciate you for asking the question. I wore this shirt for two reasons. One, if I could have made an amendment, I would have added here that black gay boys deserve to grow up too. In particular because I'm thinking about my brother Nigel Shelby, mm-hmm. Who's a 15-year-old boy who lived in Huntsville, Alabama, who unfortunately was bullied not only because he was black, but because he was also believed to be gay. Mm-hmm. I use the term same-gender loving because gay is a white political identifier, and so there's an important nuance there, but those intersectional oppressions forced Nigel to believe that dying by suicide was his only option. Mm-hmm. And what we know is that the rates of suicide have increased for young black kids in particular, yeah. Both those who are LGBTQ and those who are not. Mm-hmm. And so this is really a plea for us to do a better job of protecting our babies, yes. To ask them not just what's wrong with mm-hmm. you, but what's wrong, and to do a better job of providing them with the support they need in order to feel safe, engaged, and supported.
Yeah, yeah. I love that shirt. I love the message on it. So let's talk a little bit about June. June is Pride Month.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But what exactly does that mean to the black LGBTQ community?
Yeah, I appreciate that.
And how
that.
Are we celebrating?
Yeah, so we a lot of us aren't, right? I like to think of June as an extension of Black History Month. We would not be here if it were not for Marsha P. Johnson and other black queer leaders who mm-hmm. fought to ensure that equality existed for everyone, right? People on the basis of sex, people on the basis of racial ethnic identity, as well as sexual identity, gender orientation, and gender expression. And the reality is that throughout the country, there are so many pride celebrations, public demonstrations of people being out and being proud. But the reality is that for those of us who have intersectional identities, who are both black and LGBTQIA or same gender loving, we don't really have that luxury. Mm. The reality is that in this Pride Month, to date, there have been 6 black trans women who
yes.
have been murdered, right?
Yes.
And so what I like to remind people is that white people have the privilege of being able to come out and draw strength from that part of their identity. They get to come out with their family, they have maybe an awkward dinner, but at some point everybody comes around. They then move to a gayborhood like Hollywood, California, Boys Town, Chicago, Chelsea, New York. They then get to join leagues and social networks where they get to benefit again from that part of their identity. Black people live with other, black LGBTQ people live with other black people. We're disproportionately concentrated in the South, in states where it's legal to discriminate against us, to deny us access to housing and employment. And so the reality is that it's just not safe for us sometimes to come out.
Yeah. I like that term gayborhood though. That was
it's right.
Well, this year marks the 50th celebration or anniversary of the Stonewall Uprising,
yes.
which took place in 1969. What is the significance of Stonewall, and did black people play a major role in this, or do you ever hear about it?
The answer to that is almost always yes. Whenever you think about anything relating to efforts to ensure that our country lives up to its founding principles, particularly around liberty and equality for all, black people, black women, black young people and black queer people are often at the center. And so we would not be celebrating 50 years of the Stonewall resistance. The media called it a riot, but it was actually resistance because there were very few places where homosexual people, was a term they used at the time, could gather.
Right.
It was actually illegal for patrons to serve liquor to homosexual people because they were believed to not be able to handle their liquor and not be disruptive in public. Mm-hmm. So Stonewall was one of these places that was thought to be safe. We have to be clear that Marsha P. Johnson was in there as a black transgender woman. She was not always welcomed and safe. But the short of it is that she was one of the first people to throw a bottle to resist when the police started to come into that place to raid it. Mm-hmm. And so we would not be celebrating, again, many of the gains that the LGBTQ movement has had, in particular marriage equality recently, if it were not for Marsha P. Johnson and the efforts that she and Sylvia Rivera, who started STAR, an organization that led to so much of what we now claim connected to LGBTQ celebrations, it's all a result of her.
Yeah, thank you for schooling the people.
I love that.
My goodness.
So women are just not being protected, period. I don't care
especially
what
you're black women.
Listen, black women are just the most, we say it all the time, the most disrespected yeah. woman. Most hardworking, but the most disrespected yeah. as well. What can we do? And it doesn't matter the identity, whether you're gay, you're straight, you're queer, whatever. It just doesn't matter. Yeah. What can we do to start protecting our black women?
Yeah, I appreciate the question. I just want to acknowledge as an unapologetic member of the Mama's Boys Club that black women do all things, right?
Yes.
And it's really important for us to appreciate that when we say that we need to protect black women, that all means all. And in particular for us, that means acknowledging that black trans women are women as well, right? And so the National Black Justice Coalition has a toolkit that we're releasing soon, a gender justice toolkit, that really calls out what Malcolm X said some time ago, which is that the most disrespected person in America is the black woman.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So we have so much more work to do to address particularly the violence, the state-sanctioned violence, the intra-community violence that happens that prevents black women from showing up and showing out in the way that we always expect for you to.
Oh my goodness. Well, let's talk about June 27th, and that is National HIV Awareness Day. So what can we do to prevent, protect, and treat our people, especially our black women?
I appreciate the question, in particular because too often we talk about HIV as if it's a gay disease, but we know that it disproportionately affects black, cis, heterosexual women, right? So women that have the privilege of their gender identity being consistent with the gender that a doctor assigned them at birth. So we need to have this conversation. Three things to consider. There are a number of people that are thriving with HIV, and we need to find ways to support them. Mm-hmm. We just don't talk enough about the virus, and a lot of that has to do with the stigma. So celebrating and acknowledging that there are people living with the virus is super important. Mm-hmm. The second thing is that we have to have conversations about prevention and treatment. So all of us should be getting tested. If you are not in a monogamous, committed relationship, you should be getting tested every 6 months. If you're in a category that the CDC deems more at risk, for example, me being a same gender loving man, you should do that every 3 months. You should also take advantage of things like PEP and PrEP.
I was just about to ask
you. Yeah, pills. I take a pill every single day, PrEP, that reduces the likelihood that I will become HIV positive significantly. It's a part of a holistic health regimen, and is again about us doing everything possible to make sure that we're healthy, happy, and whole.
My goodness. Mm-hmm. And the I Elevate Conference is happening this weekend.
Yes.
We're being honored on Friday.
Yes. Yes. I'm looking forward to
yes, your participation in the conference.
So I will be thankfully having a fireside chat with my sister, our sister, Tawanda Braxton, and Bishop O.C. Allen on Thursday at 11:30 at the Westin. So just encourage everybody to come. We'll be having a version of this discussion and how it is that we can work better together.
All right, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We want to thank the one and only David Johns for all that he does for our community. For more information on all the things that he has going on, make sure you log on to www.nbjc.org.